I never looked too closely at Tailwind because I was happy with styled components. A lot of people just really seem to love it.
If you've seen my thumbnails, you might think I hate Tailwind. If you've seen my videos, you probably know I love it.
And even my own company that I work for uses Tailwind, so I think it's about time that I learn a little bit more on how Tailwind works. And since I haven't done any work on my UI library, I thought maybe let's try it there first. Let's try transitioning the UI library to a Tailwind project that can still be used in other projects. Okay, so this is the project. I think most of this stuff is pretty much the same as it was before, with a couple exceptions. So this all started when I saw this post by Sean Evening about how to set up Tailwind CSS and Storybook. Almost every time I arrive at this page, something is different about it. This one is actually updated July 2023. So I want to actually compare what my implementation was with what Sean has come up with, because the last time I tried this, it didn't work exactly because there was a package that was out of date and I had to use a different version of it. But this is how I set it up, and we'll definitely retry this setup with Sean's updated blog post. So we'll just start from top to bottom. Here's my main.js file. I'm using Storybook add-on styling with post CSS set to true. This is the manager is the same, previews the same, theme is the same, source components. The difference is that we have some Tailwind classes here, and the styles.css file just has the imports from Tailwind. The stories are pretty much the same as well, since all we're doing is just updating the styles. And then you have the post.css config.js file, you have the Tailwind config. This is the one thing that actually I got hung up for a long time on, was how to export the font with the project. And this is something I had a lot of trouble with. And eventually I just settled on having a variable tied to the font, and you import the font in your other project, and this Tailwind config will use that font as long as it's tied to these variables. So lastly, Storybook is the same, but we have this new thing called build Tailwind, which will only need to happen when we're doing a production build. So first we're going to build components, and then we're going to run build Tailwind. Because Tailwind natively supports post CSS, when running Storybook, it gets processed in real time. All right, and this is my Storybook all running, and I have a button, and the button is here, and the font's missing, but that's okay. The font will be eventually figured out at some other point in the future, and you can add the words onto the button. Apparently that's the dark theme. I see that Sean's tutorial has been updated July 2023, but looking at his example repo hasn't been updated since December. So I'm not sure how useful this is going to be. Tailwind config is pretty much the same. If I remember correctly, he had something that would run, it would watch the CSS and transpile it. But the thing is, I wanted Storybook to be responsible for converting the Tailwind into CSS using post CSS. So let's see if he did that in a tutorial. Okay, so instead of using post CSS true, he used this post CSS implementation require resolve post CSS. And what version of add-on styling am I using? Okay, I'm using add-on styling 1.next.1, and the current version is 1.3.4. So I'm going to upgrade to that version. But first I have to see what the changelog says. And then the whole point was to upgrade it to Storybook 7. So I do have an old version of it. So let's try migrating to the newest version. CSS loader v6. Any other breaking changes? There's also add-on styling setup. I remember that he was mentioning that in his tutorial. Add-on styling setup. Okay, so I'm going to adjust this to have the latest version, which is 1.3.4, running npm install. Okay, and then he uses, I believe if I do npx add-on styling setup, that should do it. Yay, did it. Okay, what did it change? A few things. Okay, it changed my add-on styling slightly, but now I have two of them. So let's get rid of the first one. And then here we're importing the index.css and have this added as well. Let's just confirm if this works. Oh, okay. Update import in your Tailwind styles file. Okay, so where is our Tailwind styles file? Styles.css. There we go. Now, let's see, did that work? I don't know, let's just rerun that. And it looks like it worked. Let's see if the dark theme works. No, that doesn't work. But the button looks fine. All right, I don't remember seeing, I don't see that dark mode thing that he had on his tutorial. we've got all of that. We've got this. Where's the dark mode? Uh-huh. Dark mode, class dark mode. Okay, there we go. And this is inside Tailwind config.js. Oh, I was looking in the wrong place. Maybe I do have it. I do have it. Now, there were some sacrifices that were made, and one of them was the font thing that I was talking about before. And another thing is, the build files are no longer in TypeScript, they're in JavaScript. So if I run a build and you look in the dist folder, you can see we have components, we have the typings files, we have some source map files for the typings, as well as the actual button, but in JS. In the last video I mentioned I wanted to keep things in TypeScript, but I did run into some issues with other projects importing this UI library, because a lot of projects don't expect there to be TypeScript in the node modules folder. Like the typing files, yes, but not actual like the source files being in TypeScript. So I had two options. One is to leverage the configurability that each project has and the flexibility that the JavaScript ecosystem offers in order to force each project to work in the way that I wanted it to work. Or the other option, which was the path of least resistance, is just publish the library with JavaScript as the dist files and only have the source files in TypeScript. In the future, that might change as more people use TypeScript. It may be preferable to have source files in TypeScript as well. But for now, the main thing that you want to do with the UI library is make sure that the developer experience is very good. Because after all, yes, people will be consuming it with their eyes, but the people who are going to be developing their projects using this UI library will be developers. The reason why I wanted to have a UI library in the first place is to completely isolate the logic from the design of the website. That way, when you're developing for design, you just have to worry about the design. When you're developing for logic, you only have to worry about the logic. And by logic, I mean like features. And one thing that's going to really help simplify the design of a website is to have some unstyled boilerplate components that I can use that have some pretty basic features that pretty much every website is going to have. This is called Headless UI, made by the same people who made Tailwind. And that's exactly what it does, is it provides you unstyled components so you can isolate the design logic from the business logic. And before I go, I just want to commit my changes, saying I updated Storybook add-on styling and also ran npx add-on styling setup.